create this client connected to the cloud that makes it possible for everybody's PC gaming experience to be as optimal as it can possibly be. And therefore, as a result of that, give you the simplicity of a game console, but the performance, scalability, and the performance of a PC.
Historically, NVIDIA's attempts at streaming games have been rocky. Back in 2013, they introduced NVIDIA Grid as the first multi-device gaming, which enabled players to stream games from Grid servers directly from their PC to any device. These games were to be sold by telecom or ISP providers as part of their subscription bundles. Come 2015, it was rebranded as GeForce Now and entered beta on the NVIDIA Shield. The service was advertised as the first cloud gaming service to stream at full high-definition 1080p quality at 60fps, with a membership cost of $7.99 per month. Note that the first 3 months were free. NVIDIA continued to improve their technology, so by 2017, a better service entered the beta with the same name, but this time, the volume of games were increased to just about any game you own from any store. Similar to the 2015 version, this also suffered from connectivity issues. Of course, we can expect this to happen because despite years of research and innovation, the cloud gaming technology hasn't really matured. Now on Feb 4, NVIDIA's very own GeForce Now finally went live. It's in direct competition against the likes of Google Stadia, PlayStation Now, and the upcoming Microsoft's Project xCloud. NVIDIA starts off their blog by highlighting their virtual and state-of-the-art GPU drivers so you can play games wherever and whenever, regardless of the power of your PC. Now, what's cool about this is you don't have to shell out extra money to be able to play the games that you already own. So, game stores such as Steam, Battle.net, Uplay, and the Epic Games Store are all part of the service. Just log into each of your accounts, download your games, and then instantly have access to them by using GeForce Now. One issue, however, is that the games of publishers who participated in the beta are not yet included. We don't know when or if it will be added sometime soon. Games such as Grand Theft Auto 5, Monster Hunter World, and Red Dead Redemption 2 are currently not available in the service, but they have so many other good games such as Cuphead, Dead by Daylight, Greedfall, and Kingdom Come Deliverance, to name a few. Regardless, this still means easy access to hundreds of games, unlike what we've seen with Google Stadia. Stadia's library currently contains only less than 30 games, such as Destiny 2, Borderlands 3, and Metro Exodus, among others. To make matters worse, even if you own the games on PC, you still have to buy it on the Google Store to be able to play it via Stadia. Now, in the case of GeForce Now, games will be added on a weekly basis depending on feedback. The maximum specs for games is still at 1080p, 60fps with a 30Mbps connection. The best experience is reached with a 50Mbps connection and a 5GHz network if playing on Wi-Fi. Because of this, NVIDIA expects to have little latency at approximately 20 milliseconds. I'm hoping to see that once NVIDIA does better in terms of latency issues, that we will see them shoot for 4K instead of 1080p as the best resolution to stream games. Now, in comparison to Google Stadia, Google VP Phil Harrison tweeted back in October that, yes, all games at launch support 4K. We designed Stadia to enable 4K 60 with appropriate TV and bandwidth. We want all games to play 4K 60, but sometimes for artistic reasons, a game is 4K 30. So Stadia always streams at 4K 60 via 2x encode. But looking at games like Red Dead Redemption 2 and Destiny 2, These didn't meet the 4K mark, streaming at 1440p and 1080p respectively. It's still worth noting that in this regard, Stadia has better specs than GeForce. Next, GeForce does automatic patching of games for you in the cloud, so you won't have to wait. On top of that, it also has crossplay, so let's say, for example, you play on the GeForce and you play with your friend who plays on the PC. That is acceptable with this service. At the moment, however, GeForce Now is only available in North America and Europe, as the NVIDIA data centers have not expanded beyond that. Now, in terms of membership tiers, there are two. We have Free and Founders. The free option gives you standard access to the service, but you can only play for 1 hour, especially during periods of high network congestion, before getting waitlisted. Note that your game sessions are still unlimited. On the other hand, the Founders plan provides priority access, a 6 hour playtime length, RTX on, meaning having ray tracing to make lighting and shadows more realistic, together with additional features in the future, and a 3 month introductory period, followed by $499 per month this 2020, similar to their membership option back in 2015. It's also worth noting that this plan is only a limited time offer. My guess is when NVIDIA reaches a certain threshold of customers, that they will be closing this specific membership option. Now, in comparison to Google Stadia, GeForce Now is much cheaper. Stadia comes in 3 tiers at the moment. Stadia Pro for $999 a month to stream games in glorious 4K 60fps and in HDR. The Stadia Base, which is free but only lets you play games in 1080p 60. And lastly, the Premier Edition at $129, which comes with 3 months of Stadia Pro, a Chromecast Ultra, and limited edition controller. I would like to further stress that as long as the game store and publishers have an agreement with NVIDIA to showcase their games and you own it, you can play these on GeForce Now without having to spend extra. Now, it's too early to say if GeForce Now is a Stadia killer, as Stadia basically dug their own grave through overpromising and overpricing.
Once you're set up, you buy the game you want, then you play it instantly. You're just a click away from buying the latest titles.
You get 4K gameplay without annoying game downloads, patches, installs, or expensive gaming hardware to buy. To play Stadia, you'll need the Stadia Founders Edition, which you can pre-order today for only $129.
Plus, there are other services whose full potential we have yet to see. What I'm looking for in these cloud gaming services are 1. The lowest latency. 2. Accessibility for all players around the world, although I know for a fact right now that this is probably a long shot. 3. The service that can provide the most number of high-quality games. And 4. The service that has the most reasonable price. If GeForce Now were only available in my country, then I would have gladly tried it out. So for those of you who can, do me a favor and let me know what your thoughts are about it. So that's it for today, guys. I'm Wisa, and thank you again for tuning in. Please remember to subscribe and hit the notifications bell to receive updates on the channel. I will be back for more game news this week. Have a good day ahead.